Hello, everybody. This is Toni Turner, and welcome to the market now as of about 1 p.m. Eastern on Friday, June the 2nd. U.S. indices touched record highs again today, but gains were limited as data showed job growth slowed in May, indicating that a bounce in the labor market is losing a little steam. Non-farm payrolls increased by 138,000 last month, below the 185,000 expected by economists. While last month's job gains should still be or could still be sufficient for the Federal Reserve to raise interest rates this month, the modest increase could raise concerns about the economy's health after GDP growth slowed in the first quarter. Odds of a rate hike at the Fed's June 13th and 14th meeting right now stand at 93.5%, according to the CME Group's FedWatch tool. And now let's go on to three charts that could give us some insight into the week to come. First of all, as we usually do, we're going to look at a chart of the S&P 500, symbol SPY. This is the exchange-traded fund that follows our S&P 500 index. Now, the new all-time high today on the SPY came in at about $244 and a couple of cents, although when I captured this chart, the SPY is standing at $243.99, so yet another new all-time high. It seems like we just keep on rolling. Okay, and then the SPY is trading above. Naturally, it would be. It's 20-day moving average, the red line. It's 50-day moving average, the green line. And it's 200-day moving average, the black line. Now, finally, we had talked last week about the RSI was kind of lagging. And we wondered if it was a bearish divergence that would possibly drag the SPY lower. However, the RSI has decided to make up some of that difference. It's now moved up just to the 70 point in its range. When it moves over 70, whenever the RSI moves over 70 on any asset, that means that it is overbought. It means that almost everyone is long this particular asset. Now, going back to that bearish divergence that we were talking about earlier, if we look at the all-time high DAT posted back here on March 1st of the SPY at $240.32. We note that the RSI here was up in totally in the overbought zone and totally over the 70 line on the scale. At this point, it's not yet over that line. So the SPY here is making a higher high here. It was a lower high there. We can still say there's a moderate bearish divergence in the RSI right now. As we can see, if we take and draw a trend line, and I'm sorry, I'm not drawing this one very straight, but if we draw a trend line, we can still see this is a lower high in the RSI. However, we could sit and argue about this all day, and we know that the most important thing is price. We can't argue with the new high on the SPY. Things are getting a little toppy again here. I've been through charts of many of the market indices and the sectors, and a lot of sectors are getting overbought here, so we do want to be careful. So if the SPY can keep moving higher into next week and continue this uptrend it's been in for quite a few years, fantastic. Again, if it needs to take a rest, it can come back down here and find support at 240 or about 2400 on the S&P 500 itself. Of course, there's the 50-day moving average is coming in here at about 237. 50-day is usually good for a little support. And of course, we're watching these lows here, which come in at about 232, 233. Those are the lows I'm watching here on the SPY to see if they do break below that, then they could continue or it could continue back on down toward the 200-day moving average. But we'll just have to see here if the SPY can continue this strength into the coming week. Our next chart that we're going to look at is the iShares Russell 2000 ETF. We watch this a lot at market potential market tops and bottoms, And Tony's Market Club, we watch it, I monitor it certainly on a daily basis, as we do want to know, we do want to get a feeling of where the market can go next, and the IWM can act as a leading indicator in this matter, in this manner. Now, today when I captured the IWM, it's trading at $140.70. We've certainly not been bored watching the IWM lately. We know it dipped last week and moved down to an intraday low to $134.64 this past Wednesday. Then, in the last 2 days, Thursday and today, it's rallied back up to over its 50-day moving average, a pretty important line as all the institutional traders watch it. And then it rallied up again today. So just when we think it's getting weak and we're worried about it, boom, it moves back up, which is a good thing. It's certainly a positive for the broader market, and we're glad to see it. So again, today the IWM is trading at $140.70, trying to head back up to this all-time high that it touched back here in April of $141.81. So we're a little over a dollar away from that. So that's going to be our resistance line here. Now, if the IWM in the coming week, if it comes back up here and it cannot move through this $141.81 high, if it can't move back up through that and continue the long-term trend that it's been in, and I mean the uptrend that it has been in for a while, if you discount this, or if you look past this trading in a range that it's been doing virtually for the whole year this year. If it can move up into and continue this uptrend, fantastic. However, if the IWM can't make this high here, then if it gets rejected here, as it was rejected here and up to a slightly lower point here, if it gets rejected again, I don't know how many more times it can come up and then rally back up. So this is kind of where the rubber meets the road here. In the coming week, we have to see if the IWM can move up past these all-time highs or if it needs to take a breather. Of course, we're watching this low here at $132.40 set in March. We're watching that very closely because that is kind of our line in the sand. Should the IWM break below that, then I'm pretty sure it's going to pressure the broad market lower. So let's see what happens in the coming week. Our final chart today is a chart of an ETF, a sector ETF we haven't looked at in quite a while. This is the Spider S&P Insurance ETF, symbol KIE. Now, as I looked at the KIE today, we can see it's trading at $87.45. Now, this particular KIE, this particular ETF has 50 holdings, as you can imagine, in the insurance business. The top holdings are First America Financial, Willis Towers Watson, Fidelity National, Allstate, Aflac. After making an all-time closing high right there on March 1st of $88.69, then the KIE started trading in a range, we can say, from about 84 to about 88. And it's been trading in this range, as you can see, after making that March 1st high. It's come down and then pretty much moved sideways for the last 3 months. Now I want to see if it can move up and over this $88 point. It's very close to it today. It's trading above the it's trading above the 20-day moving average and the 50-day moving average, which are pretty much moving in lockstep right now at about $85.70. They're moving together right there. And what I'm looking at here to see now, if the Fed raises interest rates on June the 14th, that actually can be a positive for insurance companies. So I'm going to be watching the KIE in the coming week, and if it breaks higher, I may want to take a modest long position. My stop, of course, as always, is a close below the 50-day moving average. Should the KIE, for any reason, move down and move down to close below $85, it'll be in about, say, 80 cents or so. That's about where the 50-day moving average is coming in now. Of course, it's going to move slightly in the next few days. But suffice to say, if the KIE for any reason closes below the 50-day line, then I am out. But if it manages to stay above this line, and if it can move up, possibly even take out this prior high and then move higher, it may be a long position that I will gradually scale into. Again, the market in an overall sense here is overbought. Any little thing could shake it up. So any new positions I'm getting into on a very conservative basis. Okay, and now on to next week's economic reports. But first, please join us this coming Monday, June 5th, for our next session of Toni's Market Club. We'll talk about which side of the market to trade, have a mini trading lesson, and I'll give you stocks and ETFs, their entry prices, their protective stop, and their profit targets that may be ripe for high potential trades. This is a low-priced, high-value opportunity to learn more about the market, become a smarter trader, and make more money. So please join us. For those who cannot attend our live session, it's not a problem. Our recording of our session is available to all of our members just a few minutes after the session ends. For more information and to join, go to tonysmarketclub.com. And now for our economic reports. Some months we have very, very few reports, or some weeks, I should say, we have very few reports during the month, and this is one of those weeks. So in the coming week on Monday, we have the ISM services report. On Wednesday, we have our usual weekly crude inventories. On Thursday, we have our usual weekly jobless claims and our nat gas inventories. Not much going on the economic front on Friday. Again, join us for Toni's Market Club this coming Monday. Don't miss out on this terrific opportunity to raise your trading skills and your trading profits. Until next week, keep green on your screen. I'm Toni Turner, and this is The Market Now.